We're out here looking on brand and looking luxury with our thrift store finds. Lounging at home, got some nice slippers on. There it is. Okay, cool. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, hi, my name is Marina. A little disclaimer, I'm like right next to a window and it's raining outside and it's kind of a busy street. So if you hear any background noises, I do apologize. Today's video, I thought it'd be a really cool idea to kind of go through my thrifted closet. I've been thrifting for a very long time. Hopefully this like kind of satisfies everyone's desire to go thrifting because like me personally I've been missing it so much, just like all the rest of you, and I hope that this video kind of satisfies the treasure hunt desire because that's what we all really love about thrifting. Be quiet. I hope you guys are snuggled up with a blanket right now. Grab a tea, cup of coffee, a Truly or a White Claw. I don't even care what you have. And let's get into my thrifted purse slash bag collection. As you can tell, my bag collection's not that colorful. I don't really like a lot of color in my wardrobe. I do like pops of color. I do have a few things in here. I actually got rid of a lot of purses and this is what I got left. A few things I'm actually getting rid of too. So you can see them on my Poshmark and I'll tell you which ones they are. And I will have the link down below for my Poshmark and so you guys can check those out. But anyway, let's start with the first. And this is actually a fanny pack or bum bag. It can be called different things. So I've had this for like, gosh, over 5 years. I've worn this thing hiking. I've used this for yard sales, concerts. It has a back pocket. I would put like portable charger in there and stuff like that. I'd have this one for my phone so it's easy to open. And then in here, I'd put like a little more valuable things because it's zipped shut. So this is like my ride or die fanny pack bum bag. I've thrifted this like a long time ago. So this thing's been through so much. I don't remember the prices for a lot of these items, but typically what I pay for something like this would be around $3 to $4. I have here is this little cute shoulder bag. So this is like an olive color. I showed this in like my massive thrift haul of name brand items. I will put that video up there. So this one is by the brand Mondani. I'm not really sure. It definitely has like a vintage vibe to it with gold hardware. It's a pretty good size bag. I definitely would use it to just kind of run errands or run around town. Whoa, there we go, okay. Damn. So this next bag is this little, I don't even know what I would call this because it's really quite short for a crossbody. I guess if you wanted it to be like all up in this area, it works. I don't know how I feel about that. I love this faux fur detail. It's kind of like you flip it and you're like, whatever you're feeling, you can do it. You can use it as a handbag as well. I got this secondhand. So this is a mix of like thrifted and secondhand items. And I don't consider Plato's Closet consignment shops as thrifting at all. I don't think that is the true definition of thrifting. I'll let you know if it is a thrifted item or a secondhand item. So I got this at Plato's Closet. This is actually from Zara. I'm gonna sell this one. So if you're interested in this bag, check out my Poshmark. I'll hopefully have it up by the time this video goes up. I'll try to get that going for you guys if you guys are interested in this bag. So the next bag is this shoulder bag. I also hauled this in my major name brand thrift haul that I was talking about with this olive green one. So this is a more structured bag. The other one was a little bit worn in, had like less structure to it. It could definitely fit more items. I only used this like one time, I think. It's a dark navy color. It's not 100% like in my color palette for like my style and my wardrobe, so I am gonna cough this one up. So this one is actually already up on my Poshmark. Hopefully by the time this video goes up, it is still up. So if you're interested in this one, and this one opens up like that, and it's in like really good condition, but I do love this one because it does have an adjustable strap. I haven't even got a chance to wear it because I kind of forgot about it, but it's like one of my most favorite shoulder bags that I found. It's probably like my top two, I would say. So this is just a black Guess bag. It's not Prada, but it definitely looks like it because obviously that little triangle. If you're a really big fan of Prada, Guess is a really good dupe option. It's just a more affordable option with like still having the same style that you are kind of attracted to, because I mean, look at that. I love everything about this purse. I love the length of it. I don't think it's too far up in my armpit. I love the material and find that it's actually very spacious. I don't pay more than $10 for a bag. I think I probably wear gold more than silver, so this is definitely up my alley. I love the details for the strap. The strap is what sold me on it. I recently sold the exact bag in tan on my Poshmark, so I don't have that one, but this is by the brand St. John's Bay. Definitely a summer bag. I'm on the edge of keeping it, but I think I'm gonna sell it because I just have way too many bags. I love that this like straw wicker bag is black, because normally you would find them in the usual tan beige color. Very different. I think it makes quite a statement with the bamboo handles as well. This is really cute, but I'm gonna give it up. Okay, I'm gonna give it up. Oh, this one I actually shown in the same haul as these shoulder bags. I decided that I'm gonna sell it. Originally it came with this strap, and then I added on this bonus strap. I think it's really cute. So you can kind of like choose what strap you want because they're both removable. You can wear both or just one or the other. And this is by Marc New York. You can't really tell, but here in the mirror, that's about, it hits like the hip length. If you are a snacker, gotta have your water bottle with you. If you have to have a full can of hairspray and a brush in your purse, this is the bag for you. So this will be up on my Poshmark. I'm mostly getting rid of a lot of bags because I just don't have the room for them. So I have to get really, really picky. This next bag is also like a crossbody. You can't really see it, but in the mirror right here, you can kind of see it hits at the same length. I am also selling this one on my Poshmark. I've used it like once or twice. I guess I just don't gravitate towards black bags as much as I used to, but I guess I gravitate towards like the neutral earthy tones. I just like light colors. My husband loves dark colors, but we're totally opposite when it comes to that. It just says Mark on it with a period at the end, so I'm assuming that's the brand. So this is the little closure. Feels like I'm buckling my seatbelt. It has really a lot of room. So if you're looking for a small bag but has plenty of room for things, this is your bag. It obviously has like some pockets in there, but my favorite thing about it is this top part right here. What the heck? I feel something in there. Let's see what's in it. So if you open up this top part, it becomes extra storage. And look what we found. We found a brand new NYX soft matte lip cream. What the heck? Another bag up for grabs on my Poshmark is this snake skin print handbag. Clutch, you can call it whatever you want. Love it so much. This is actually by the brand Nine & Co. It opens up with a magnetic clasp right there. We styling walking with this thing for sure. This bag looks really nice with like earthy tones. It also looks really nice if you have like a full black outfit. This looks really nice with that as well. So have fun with it, play around with it. It is really cute statement bag for your wardrobe. This is probably, is it my smallest bag? It is my smallest bag. This is Liz Claiborne, I believe. Let me double check just to make sure I'm right on that. Yes, it is. And so one of my favorite things to look for in the thrift store is Liz Claiborne. You can definitely spot this up on my Instagram. I have a few photos with this bag. I really love it. It's a nice statement. I noticed that in my wardrobe, if I go for a statement bag, I usually go for red for some reason. I also have a red Guess backpack, which is gonna be on my Poshmark, but that thing was like my ride or die. I just don't use backpack as much as I used to, so it does not fit very much. And when you have a big iPhone, and the phone nowadays are just humongous, so like your phone will take up like 80% of this, like these kind of purses. You guys should definitely check out like ThredUp, Poshmark, thrifting for Liz Claiborne, because her stuff is really good. The quality is really nice, and I will show you, I have another bag in here that is from Liz Claiborne, and you guys will die over it. It is really, really nice. I don't hope you die over it, but you're gonna like fall in love with it. It's really nice. Oh snap, I skipped one on accident, so. My bad. Here's another bum bag, fanny pack, whatever you want to call it. This one's more like a belt bag because it actually can fit along your belt loops of your pants, dresses as well. If your dress has like any kind of loop, these are really cool to wear and style up your outfit. This one's secondhand. This one's not thrifted. This one came from Plato's Closet and I got it for about $20. This is a Michael Kors quilted bag, and you can wear it like this if you want to kind of be on trend with that whole wearing the bum bags across your chest. I have a lot of pictures on my Instagram as well of me styling this. I usually just wear it around the waist. I love this bag for concerts because a few places I've gone, they make you wear like really compact bags. Like I walked into a concert with a bag similar to like this size, the black S one, and they said it was too big. I'm like, how is that too big? I don't understand. I know a lot of us might not think it's like realistically a bag that you would want to use on the daily, but they're good to have. They're just good for times, obviously, when you just want to be hands-free. So if you don't have any of these kind of bags in your collection, I would highly recommend start adding them because they will help you eventually. I mean, even if it's a few times a year, they're still good to have. So this is one of my most recent bags I thrifted because it still has a tag on it, and I got this back, gosh, a few months ago, I think probably like February, before the stay-at-home order happened. And this one is from Value Village and it has the price of $6.99. I remember I actually got this for half off. I don't know when I'll wear it. It seems more like a special occasion bag. The shoulder strap is a metal gold material, and oh, the brand is Rampage. This is obviously Burberry inspired. Remember thrifting this? Very clearly, even though I've had it for over 2 years, I got this at a Goodwill. I remember paying about like $7 for it. And I was like, dang, that's a really good price for something that looks, you know, similar to Burberry. And I don't own anything actually by Burberry, but I really love their signature print and their plaid. So I think it's really, really classy. And I think it's a really good fall kind of bag. Hi, as you can see, the bags are all gone. I was putting the bags away and I found one. For some reason, I skipped over on accident. I thrifted this one. It is also by Liz Claiborne. It is obviously like super adorable. I don't expect anything less from Liz Claiborne. I love the brand overall. It's one of my favorite brands to thrift for sure. This next bag, oh, I clearly remember thrifting this bag. This is, I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm probably gonna get it wrong. Rioni. Don't know. It's R-I-O-N-I. For the sake of this video, I'm just gonna call it Rioni. So it says Rioni Moda Italia. You can tell by touching it, by looking at the wear of it, that it is real leather, especially on the back. And then on the bottom is probably the only flaw. There's only two spots that look like this. Otherwise, the bottom looks like that. Really the only flaw that I can find on it. It is like a crossbody. I have used this for my laptop in the past, but obviously it doesn't fully close. My laptop kind of peeks out. And then it has the brand all over the strap. I got this from Goodwill for $7. When I found this, I wasn't familiar with the brand at all. And so I Googled it while I was in the store because I was like, this seems like a really nice, well-made bag. So I Googled it and the price range was about between $100 to $300. So it depends, I think, on the design, how new it is. This is definitely like, it seems a little bit like an older design, but I really like it.
This is the inner tag, so you guys can see that.
And then I remember going to a Value Village like weeks later, and I came across like a handbag, and it was the same brand. It wasn't as cute though. This was definitely a lot cuter, but they were pricing it at like $35 or $40 or something like that, and I was like, I was just like, thank God, like I walked out with this one at the price I found it for, because I was hesitant at first, but I was like, you know what? For $7, I just couldn't beat a well-made bag like this. The next bag screams summer, hello, beach, picnics. This I thrifted actually last year. I got it at Value Village at the end of summer, so it was actually going into like September, October-ish, so I didn't get a chance to use it last year. This is the Liz Claiborne one I was telling you guys about. I love this one so much. I have not worn this one either. This is really well made. The handles were my favorite part, and it has the Liz Claiborne embossed into the handles, and inside is solid pink. I actually thrifted this in a thrift haul on my channel, so I will put the card for that video up here. I got this for about $5, if I remember correctly. Now, so this one is secondhand. I got this one at Plato's Closet. I paid $10 for this. I use this a lot during the winter. I love the faux fur lining on the top. It's very spacious, so let me, first off, like, wow. I actually like using this bag. If you're doing like a weekend trip, it's a good weekender bag. So this bag, I looked on the bottom. I didn't know this until like right now. This is a Barnes & Noble bag, which is really weird because I didn't know Barnes & Noble sold bags. All right, we're down to the last two. This one I've had for a very long time. I remember getting this, oops, it's a little bent, sorry. I remember getting this at a Goodwill. And this is from Who What Wear. This is like a bag that they would sell at Target. I use this actually for work, and it's been my ride or die. It's so sturdy and so strong. The material is nice and plush. It has these additional handles, which I think is actually pretty cool. I don't really find this very often in a lot of bags. I remember paying about $7 for this. And the very last one is more like a weekender travel bag. I hauled this on my Instagram. So this one's nowhere to be found on YouTube, but this is by the brand Furla. If you're not familiar with Furla, it's actually a really good brand. They make their stuff in Italy. I actually paid $7 for this bag. So it closes with this little clasp right here. And then you open it up, it has a very structured, sturdy top to it. And then inside, you will find the logo. It also has their name stamped in the handle. I love the bottom. I love when bags have this feature, because just like the other bag I showed you, this one right here, where the bottom of it is damaged because when you set it down or on the floor, I love that this one has kind of like more added protection. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you stuck around, don't forget to subscribe, like this video, comment down below your favorite bag in my collection. Also, feel free to start conversation, like what's your style and what do you look for in handbags when you thrift. I like to hear what people look for and like their tips, so feel free to share those down below. Otherwise, stick around for more thrifting content from me and more. Hope you guys enjoyed this video while you guys are stuck at home, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.